الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه ولبيته ومن اتبع سنته أجمعين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله تبارك وتعالى قل يا أهل الكتاب تعالوا إلى كلمة سواء بيننا وبينكم ألا نعبد إلا الله ولا نشرك به شيئا ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا أربابا من دون الله فإن تولوا فقولوا اشهدوا بأننا مسلمون يا أهل الكتاب لما تحاجون في إبراهيم وما أنزلت التوراة والإنجيل إلا من بعده أفلا تعقلون ها أنتم هؤلاء حاججتم فيما لكم به علم فلما تحاجون فيما ليس لكم به علم والله يعلم وأنتم لا تعلمون ما كان إبراهيم يهوديا ولا نصرانيا ولكن كان حنيفا مسلما وما كان من المشركين إن أولى الناس بإبراهيم للذين اتبعوا وهذا النبي والذين آمنوا والله ولي المؤمنين ود الطائفة من أهل الكتاب لو يضلونكم وما يضلون إلا أنفسهم وما يشعرون صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم والعاقبة للمتقين ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته الحمد لله الله سبحانه وتعالى عز وجل شأنه have given us this beautiful Jumat al-Mubarak today we have gathered to perform the Salat al-Jum'ah بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ May Allah accept us and accept our ibadat and our hasanat and give us the blessing in the dunya and the akhirah. I recited the ayah from Surah Aal Imran in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing to the people of his scripture. Today, we see that few events have happened in the last few days, especially Thanksgiving happened, then Christmas, and then the New Year. And so many other events are going on with this time. Time is limited. I will try to, inshallah, share some thoughts. Inshallah, may Allah accept us. In this Surah Al Imran, verse number 64 to 69, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Say, O beloved Muhammad Rasulullah, to his people of the scripture, that O people of books, come to a word which is common among us and you, that is, we will worship none but Allah. And we will not make partners with Allah with anything what we do. And we will not take our rabbis and our priests as our Lord, our Rabb, except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you turn away from such a statement, bear witness that we are Muslim. O you people of the scripture, why you argue in the matter of Ibrahim? And you know that the Torah and Injil, the Gospel and the Torah was revealed after him. Do you not have an intellect to understand it? And it is a matter that you can argue about that what you have a knowledge of, but why do you argue in the matter which you have no knowledge about? And Allah has all the knowledge, what you know. And Ibrahim was neither a Jew or a Christian, but he was a monotheistic believer of one God, a worshipper of one God as a Muslim. And he was not among the polytheist or idol worshipper. Indeed, among the mankind, whoever about the Ibrahim, they are close to him, that who obey this Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we believe with him. And indeed Allah is the friend and the guardian and protector of those who are believers as mu'min. And a group of people of the scripture intentionally wants to misguide you. And they do not misguide anyone except themselves. And do you not have a common understanding or intellect about that matter? It is the matter where we know that after Thanksgiving, we had Christmas in this country and all over the world where they celebrate the birth of Isa alayhi salam. Obviously, Isa alayhi salam was born, but not on the time when it has been celebrated, according to the knowledge. That date ripens in Middle East in fall, in sometime in September, not in December. And this is a pagan day which was popular among the Greco-Roman culture. The sun, S-O-N, god of the sun god, S-U-N. Suraj ke bete ki paidaish ka din manaya jata tha. The shortest night is the December 25th, and that's what it is considered. And pagans used to celebrate it, and at that time, the Christians of the faith, people of the faith of Christianity adopted it, and because they had to hide their faith, they could not celebrate because of the persecution. And it became part of the Christianity where Isa alayhi salam have not commanded this as a day or is no knowledge of confirmation on that. This is not from Muslim literature, this is from the other literature. And then in Surah Maryam, there is an incident in understanding some of the significance of this surah. Surah Maryam was revealed during the early years in the life of Mecca of Nabi alayhi salatu was salam. And we know that in the about 5th or 6th, 7th year, between 5th and 6th year of the Hijrah, when Nabi alayhi salatu was salam was about 45 years of age, and Muslims were persecuted in Mecca. At that time, they were forced to flee Mecca. And when they fled from Mecca, Nabi alayhi salatu was salam advised them to go to live in Abyssinia, which is today's Ethiopia. And the king of Abyssinia was a very kind Christian king. And Muslims have a relation with the Christian people. And he was one of the kind person. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam said he will give you protection and it will be a better place for you to live. And among them, the 5 couples, husband and wife, young couples, among them was Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu anhu, Uthman ibn Mat'un radiallahu anhu, and Jafar Tayyar radiallahu anhu, and their wife. Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu was married to the Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam daughter, Umm Kulsum, and she was with him. So Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam said, after Ibrahim alayhi salam, Uthman and his wife, that means the daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasalam, first couples who immigrated for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When they were there, the Quraysh found that they have fled and they are going to be getting away and maybe spreading their message and telling the world about what is being persecution has been committed upon them in the Mecca. So they sent Abdullah ibn Rabi'ah and Amr ibn As. At that time they were not Muslim, but Amr ibn As was a very, very talented man who had a very great skill of communication. So he went with a lot of gifts to the king Negus, which is also Najashi Shah is the name is known for that person. So when they brought the gift, they brought it to the courtiers, as typically done in today's world as well. When you visit a court of a king, you do this thing. And they brought him the gifts and they tried to soften their situation in matter of relationship because they were the government of that time in Mecca. And king allowed them a visit. And they said that few youth have escaped and fled from our country. And they are actually ignorant and uneducated. At that time, king said, I cannot turn them to you unless give them the audience. And Muslims decided that Jafar Tayyar radiallahu anhu ibn Abi Talib, the elder brother of Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, he became the spokesperson for Muslims and he presented to the king. And king asked them that, what is the matter with you people? What is this people have come here to pick you up or to get you back to the country? Jafar radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, we were ignorant, we had no knowledge. We were worshipping idols. We would have no respect for anybody. We were killing our daughters, burying them alive. And we were involved and indulged in a lot of wrongdoing. And in the midst of this darkness, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent us this Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he guided us and saved us. And once we start believing in him and he taught us to be caring and righteous and to be respectful to your neighbors and worship none but one God and do not worship these idols. And so when he finished his speech, the king said, there is nothing wrong I see in these people. They are neither rebellious and they are not bad people. I'm not going to let them leave my country. You cannot take them. They are free to live in my country. Right before leaving, Amr ibn As said to Abdullah ibn Rabi'ah that tomorrow I'm going to present some situation to the king where he will definitely will turn on against these young people. Abdullah ibn Rabi'ah also was not Muslim by that time, but he was a little more kind-hearted and he said, don't do this thing so that these people are still our relatives and our community. Amr ibn As did not listen to him, and next day he presented to the case to the king that he said, ask these people what they believe about Jesus, son of Mary, Isa ibn Maryam, that what their beliefs are. The king got a little bit upset that because he was very religious and his court was full of the rabbis and priests. And they opened their books and they brought out the knowledge and they said, let's have another discussion. So at that time, Jafar radiallahu ta'ala anhu had consultation with the other Sahaba, and they decided, no matter what happened to us, we are going to speak the truth. And the truth was Surah Maryam was revealed at that time, some ayahs and surahs were revealed. And he is presented them Surah Maryam, and he started with few words, Kaf ha ya insaf. Zikr rahmat rabbika abduhu zakariya is nada rabbuhu nada'an khafiya. And then he keep going on and on. And when he read in this situation, what happens is that the king and all the people in the court have tears flowing from their eyes. And he described that for us, Isa alayhi salam is what it says in Quran. قَالَ إِنِّي عَبْدُ اللَّهَ أَتَانِيَ الْكِتَابَ وَجَعَلْنِي نَبِيًّا وَجَعَلْنِي مُبَارَكًا أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُ وَأَوْسَانِي بِالصَّلَاةِ وَزَكَاةِ مَا دُمْتُ حَيًّا وَبَرٌّ بِالْوَالِدَةِ وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْنِي جَبَّارًا شَقِيًّا وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حيا ذلك عيسى بن مريم قول الحق الذي فيه يمترون ما كان لله أن يتخذ من ولد سبحانه إن إذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون وإن الله ربي وربكم فاعبدوه هذا صراط مستقيم. So he recited these words. At that time, king picked up a little speck from the floor, and he said, our faith and their faith is not farther distance than this speck of wood. And this is where the branch he showed them. At that time, the priest and his court were a little upset that why king is getting so soft with them. At that time, he said, it doesn't matter what you believe. This is the truth. Isa alayhi salam is neither more or less than what exactly they have said. And he embraced Islam also. And he allowed them to live in his country. At that time, Muslims were protected. And then report came in that Surah Najm was revealed, and Surah Najm was recited in the Haram Kaaba, and all the kuffar, and the last words went into the sajda. So they got the news that Islam is being accepted by the kuffar of Quraysh. So they came back, and when they arrived back, and they found that the situation is not the truth. What they heard was not the correct information. And things have been worse than when they left. And this was the first hijrah, first immigration to Habsha, a Christian country by the Muslims. When the Muslim went to the Christian country as a companion of Rasulullah, they did not leave their faith. They still stood up and spoke the truth. Similar situation what we have. We have immigrated to the country which is a Christian country, but there's no need for us to leave our faith and compromise our belief just because we are living in a country which is not being majority Muslim. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects the iman, and the time is there to understand the fact that when this holidays come, when these high season days are coming, Muslims should rather do Surah Maryam and translation of Surah Ali Imran and give it to our friends and neighbors that we believe in Jesus. We celebrate Isa alayhi salam, and we know in the Quran Allah has celebrated his birthday. So we believe in Isa alayhi salam, but we do not worship him, and we do not believe that he is a son of God, nor he is a liar. This is what's been said. Either he's a God or he's a liar. Our position is different. Neither he's a liar nor he is God, but he is a powerful, mighty messenger of Allah, whose birth was immaculate, which is the belief of them. Whose walk on the water, we believe in that. He raised the dead, we believe in that. He could tell what has been hidden and what has been eaten and what has been kept in the home. So all these, he could heal the leper and blind and all that. We differ in the way they worship him, the way they believe him. We do not worship any other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We do not believe in the crucifixion. We do not believe in the crucifixion. This is two differences which we have, and he was neither crucified. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on the day of judgment will question Isa alayhi salam and his mother. And they will be questioned, did you claim or did you say? This is the conversation Quran mentions about what will happen in the day of judgment. وَإِسْقَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَى ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ أَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخَذُونِي وَأُمِّي إِلَٰهِينَ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ قَالَ سُبْحَانَكَ مَا يَكُونَ لِي أَنْ أَقُولَ مَا لَيْسَ لِي بِحَقٍّ إِنْ كُنْتُ قلته فقد علمت تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسك إنك أنت العلام الغيوب ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني به أن أعبد الله ربي وربكم وكنت عليهم شهيدا ما دمت فيهم فلما توفيتني كنت أنت الرقيب عليهم وأنت على كل شيء شهيد إن تعذبهم فإنهم عبادك وإن تغفر لهم فإنك أنت العزيز الحكيم قال الله هذا يوم ينفع الصادقين صدقهم لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك الفوز العظيم لله ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن وهو على كل شيء قدير. These are the last ayah from Surah Al-Ma'idah. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask Isa alayhi salam. This is the conversation will happen between Allah and Isa alayhi salam. That Isa, son of Mary, did you say to the mankind that take me and my mother as a god or as a divine being to be worthy of worship except Allah or other than Allah? He will say, my Lord, glory be to you. Ma yakuna li an aqulu ma laysa li bihaq. Whatever I say, nothing could be then other than the truth. And you, in kunta qultuhu faqad alimtu. Whatever I have said, you have the knowledge of it. وَمَا فِي نَفْسِي وَلَا عَلْمُ مَا فِي نَفْسِي. And I have nothing knowledge what you have, but you have all the knowledge what I know. And you have the knowledge of the unseen. And nothing I have said other than what you have commanded me, that أَنَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ رَبِّي وَرَبُّكُمْ. That Allah is my Lord and your Lord, so worship Him alone. And وكنت عليهم شهيدا. And you were the witness of what I have said to them. ما دمت فيهم. And فلما توفيتني. When I was among them and when I was given wafat, when you collected me, then you were with them. So you are the witness what happened. Now Allah Isa alayhi salam will be kind towards his people for worrying about the people who worship him. So he will supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way, إن تعذبهم. If you work, punish them, they are your slaves. And if you forgive them, you are all wise and almighty and all powerful. Allah will say, this is the day when the truthful will be benefiting from the truth what they have spoken of and done to. For them there is a Jannah, the paradise under which the rivers are flowing. They will abode there forever and ever. And Allah will be radi with them and they will be radiyallahu anhum radu anhum. So Allah will be pleased with them and they will be pleased with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is the greatest of the success, everlasting, never-ending success they will achieve. And Allah belongs to all the dominions of heavens and earth, whatever is between them. And He has the destiny and power over everything. So this is our time to share this information of Surah Maryam, Surah Maida, Surah Ali Imran to our fellow neighbors and citizens and Christians who we are working with them, that they should know the translation of these verses should be shared as Ja'far radiallahu ta'ala anhu shared the Surah Maryam with the king. Don't need to make any preaching and no need to do anything except conveying the message of Allah in the words of Quran and the translation of those words to be given to them. And they will themselves comprehend it. Allah's to open their heart. Whenever we give something to somebody, we make dua, Ya Allah, this is my limit. Beyond is your authority. Give this person guidance and save this person from hellfire and his family and all the country. So this is our goal, should be in the life to do it. With this, the coming of the new year, we should know there is a Quran, a very smallest, shortest of the surah, Wal-Asr. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. The mankind is indeed in loss, except those. The time is passing by the time humanity is in loss. The time is passing and every year the solar system is changing and the lunar system is bringing a year. For us as a Muslim, lunar or solar does not need to make us think any negative or positive. These are the turning of the days. There's days in Islamic calendar, there is a value for the sun days because we make salah with the sun timing. But then there is a night in which the Quran was revealed. So there are days and nights. For us, it is not matter whether you follow a lunar or solar calendar. Islam prefers a lunar calendar that was established by our elders. We follow that in the latter.
And when it comes to world matter, when the people follow solar candor, we don't have a problem with it. But we don't have to greet it because there are certain things in there. We need to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like any other corporate people, they have a resolution for every year. Like every Muslim have a resolution for every moment and every hour and every day and every month and every year of his life or her life. That we should have a resolution that where we were up till now and where we are today and where we want to be tomorrow. Just one little thing. In the day of judgment, when the mu'mineen will be entering, inshallah, we will all be entering the paradise. The one thing people will regret of the Jannah, nothing they will ever regret, except one regret they will have. What that regret is, the time I spend in my life without the zikr of Allah. Because they will see what is the reward of whatever zikr of Allah we do. We should never be ever without in our mind and conscious efforts, without the remembering of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Qiyaman wa qawudan ala junubi. Every position is standing, sitting and lying down. Yazkurun Allah qiyaman wa qawudan ala junubi. So every position wherever we are in, we should remember the zikr of Allah. Why? Just a very small example. How much efforts we spend in doing everything to conversing, to emate a thing. Suppose if you want to build a tree or if you want to build a building, how much efforts we have to make planning and all this and that? To put a tree in the ground, we need to put the seed and make sure we water it, we do the efforts. Ask a farmer who have done the farming. How much it takes of a person to have a crop? When we say only once, subhanallah, how much it took? Subhanallah, say with me, subhanallah. How much it took? Less than a fraction of a second. How much is the ajr? The person in the Jannah, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, it is a plain ground. With your subhanallah, you plant trees in there. Each tree will be how long? For one subhanallah? As soon as I said subhanallah, you said subhanallah, a tree planted in the paradise. How big is that tree will be giving the shade? A person on the horseback will ride 500 years of journey. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah. Allahu Akbar. Zikr Allah should be continually being done. And what happened when we consciously do it, when we subconscious situation come in, it is being noted, certain accident happened, a person died and they were playing the music on their car. And the paramedics asked them, the Muslims, to recite the kalma. Everybody's born on the kalma. Departing on the kalma is the requirement of a believer. And they could not recite the kalma because they were listening to the music which was anti-Islamic type. So zikr Allah should be done continuously, and if we are not even in the tahara, we can still send salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 70 times more ajr comes to us. 70 times, 10 sin washed off, 10 darajat raised, 10 hasanat. Malaika sent 10 salawat, Allah sent 10 salawat. How much reward we have for one? Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala ali Muhammad. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Zikr Allah should be continued, and we should plan what we are going to do this year. There are certain tasks which we cannot do, which will find lack of motivation. Fixing the world is not possible for me. But at least I can plant one seed. I can do one act of kindness to myself, to the people, to the family, to the loved ones, to the neighbors, to the community, and for the house of Allah. You know that since the COVID happened, whole life has changed. Humanity have never seen such thing. And we do not know whether this will ever be returned back to the same thing or not. 3 minutes. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have given us this opportunity to come to the Jummah. Remember, masajid, buyutullah fil ardi masajid, they need the donation. Construction is going on. I'm sure people have blessed and have helped the masjid with the donation and construction. Please make sure we should not stop our donation to the masjid. Nobody ever got poor by doing the khair, but doing the sadaqah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not take the loan. So when we give it to the masjid, do not think you are giving to the administration. Think of giving it to Allah. Otherwise the ajr will be lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for whom we do it. Whatever our ability is, to the best of the ability, not just little ability, best of our ability. So we need to make sure these masajid continue to be flourish and prosperous. Our imam has been taken care of. Our community has been taken care of. None of us is perfect. We all make mistakes. And this is what Islam teaches. I'm going to let go of somebody does wrong to me. I will pardon from the person I've done wrong to. These are the two things, if we can make a resolution, might improve our personality of being. Muslims are one of the world's most donating nation in the world. Muslims, we give so much sadaqat and hasanat, but we give it to others, not to the loved ones. We want to give charity to our brother and sisters to just get them get by. But if we give them enough, they can become better than us. That is not in our book. Our plan should be my brother, my sisters, my friends, my children, my loved ones, my parents should be better than me. That is the success. What we wish for our children, we should start wishing it for everybody. And that is the best thing which will work for us in the hereafter. Nabi alayhi salatu was salam said, bring the poor and destitute of your community to me. Because of their existence, we get the risk so that we can spend upon them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala test some by giving and some by depriving. So we should not be the hand below, we should be the hand above. And that should be the resolution of this new year. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us, protect us, and give us the iman in life and iman, and death is life in Islam and death in iman, and our families to be protected from this disease. One last word. There are a lot of wrong information about the vaccine is going on. That is all lie. Vaccine is made with the RNA of our body, and they are talking about DNA. They're totally ignorant. Anybody can put a YouTube nowadays on social media. Do not be misguided. This virus is a killer virus. This is really a serious illness. Anybody above certain age must take it. But everybody who's been offered, take it. It is a protection. We do not know how long it is going to be protected. They're saying about 6 months to a year, but we don't know. But if it's a vaccine is offered to you, take it. And be careful, please wear the mask. It is the only thing proven social distancing has saved people. Anybody who did not observe the social distancing has suffered. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he called for somebody from the virus or other reason, does not look at what degree you have, how much wealthy you are, what generation and race you are, your ethnicity, your social status. People who are non-observant have died from that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the hikmah. Wa akhiru da'wana anil hamdulillahi rabbil alamin.